So let's pull up our socks and make a stab at constructing a quasi-scientific analogy between verbal and musical terms. I say quasi-scientific because in using linguistic analogy, I should, strictly speaking, be committed to scientific method. But I am not a scientist. I will inevitably make certain statements in one context which would be false in another. Even scientists freely admit that they do this. So did Nietzsche, so did Kierkegaard, and so does Chomsky by his own say-so. And how much truer of me. Therefore, I am restricted to hypothesizing and speculating. If I'm lucky, I may strike a nugget or two, and if I'm really lucky, I may suggest some hints that will stimulate further thought among those of you who are scientifically well-grounded. Okay, let's examine one of the many attempts that have been made to establish consistent correspondences between verbal and musical elements. How about starting with this simple equation? A note equals a letter. Now, by extension, that equation should yield this one. A scale equals an alphabet. That is, all the notes we use equal all the letters we use. But whose notes and whose alphabet? The 12 notes of our Western chromatic scale? Or the 5 notes of the Chinese pentatonic scale? And which alphabet? The German, the Russian, the Arabic? Well, so much for that one. We've arrived at chaos, and we obviously need a better system.